stalk cut plant typically adds about 20 to 25 days to that same cycle. Okay, it's about on average. It's about where you're getting. Okay. The other thing too with a stalk cut is you're getting a much lower yield because the plant with stalk cut, the whole concept of brining, it's sold to you as picking the leaf at optimum ripeness so it's the best taste. That's not true. It's picked when it's at the greatest weight, is why they prime tobacco. Okay? Because they make more money by doing the priming than they do by doing the stalk cutting. Because instead of getting all the biggest leaves and the little leaves at the top, you're allowing all the leaves to get bigger as they're being primed. Okay? There is some truth to the fact that when you do the priming, the top leaves are in the field a little bit longer and they do get a little bit more body. But ultimately, when you do the stalk cutting, those same leaves are getting a lot more nutrients in the curing process, so all the leaves get a lot more body, a lot more oils, and a lot more nutrients during the curing process. But the reason why they prime is for money. It's not because that's when it tastes best optimum right now. And all this tobacco really, I mean, priming didn't really become popular until about, what, the 60s?
That's a good question.
Yeah, I think it's about, well, he may know better, it's about the 60s when they started to actively prime tobaccos.
So according to history, the tobacco came in the
50s.
So then it started to go all the way to the highest quickest point in the 70s.
At what point did they start priming instead of stalk cutting?
¿En qué punto, en qué año fue que en vez de hacer los cortes, cortaban todo el tallo de la planta?
¿En qué etapa?
¿En qué año más o menos?
¿En los 70, 70, un poquito antes de la guerra? Sí, como en los 70.
Como en 75, más o menos.
Sí, más o menos, pero era tabaco burre, que se usaba, la tabacera latán,
para
cigarrillos, lo picaba, para
tomar. Tani was a tobacco company that used to be in Nicaragua. They went to bankrupt, and they were using a burley tobacco, and that was in 1975, and that eso fueron los que empezaron con el prime, con el corte, con el tabaco.
O sea, en lo que donde yo manejo hace unos 30 años, tabaco burley lo cortaban así ellos, pero vinieron ya los cubanos, ¿no? Así porque el burley no lo cerraban los cubanos.
I don't think the Cubans started doing the mines until like the 50s. The problem is we need somebody really old.
I have actually photos from the book. There's a book called The History of the New World. It's written by an Italian guy in 1565. He was just a traveler. Came from Milan to the New World, Hispaniola. This is only, 1460 years later than Columbus. And there's pictures. He traveled through Nicaragua and Honduras. He mentions Nicaragua and he mentions tobacco.
Right.
And he has actually sketched drawings of the old, the Indian, they were just the palm tree, the barren houses. And it looks like it's just leaves. It's not I'll have to show you that picture.
Yeah, it's interesting. Yeah. I don't think the priming became a practice all the way.
I would say that the Cuban, that's what he said. The first Cuban that came here to Nicaragua, that was right after the Cuban Revolution, those were the ones that brought the priming